Welcome to Wintergatan Wednesday. In this series, we are going to answer the ultimate question. Have I lost my marbles, or am I making a modern masterpiece? That is the question. In this episode, we're going to talk about the fish stair. It's a marble lifting technique, among many others. This fish stair was built for the first marble machine, but was never implemented. I ended up using only a conveyor belt. And for the marble machine next, I actually made a fish stair in the absolutely first sketches. So this is not feature creep. I can show you. Fish stair, gears, piston, steps, drop-off, pickup. So it was on the first drawings, so no feature creeping here. To understand the challenges with designing a perfect fish stair for the Marble Machine X, you need to know some basic information, and that is, first of all, we need to lift 8 marbles per crank turn. That's the value that we have calculated for the Marble Machine X to be able to play like a techno song for a long time without getting too few marbles into the marble divider. So that's our first, 8 marbles per crank turn. And the fish stair is driven by this shaft. And the crank has a timing wheel here on the crankshaft. This timing wheel has a ratio of 1 and goes to this timing wheel that has a ratio of 2. So this wheel goes half the speed from this, right? That timing wheel goes over to this side where we have the pistons. So these two pistons on this camshaft here that is driven by this axle from the timing belts I just showed you will go exactly in time with the music. That will be so cool, I think. And they will go half tempo compared to the crank. So they go up on these linear bearings here and they power the fish stair here. So piston A power these groups of steps and piston B power these groups of steps. And now I needed to calculate how much height I could get out of this. I needed to calculate how long this step has to be higher than this step in order for the marble to have time to jump to the next step. And to make that calculations, I started out with making a slow motion test. So what I did is that I took some slow mo shots in 100 frames per second. And I have a frame counter here. So we can see if I can toggle that, let's say this is the first frame where the marble actually can move to the next step. I can toggle forward and we can see that it's about 10 frames from 3 to 13 something there. We now know that we need 1/10 of a second for a marble to jump from a step from a step. Let's make a worst case scenario for our calculations. Let's say we play a song in 200 BPM. That's really fast. That means that the crank turns 200 times for 1 minute. The cam offset for the pistons is 30 millimeter, which gives each fish stair step a travel of 6 centimeter. And after doing some bad maths with all these numbers, I realized that I could place the steps 45 millimeters apart and still have time for the marbles to climb the stair. But I didn't feel really certain, so I made a stop motion sketch in Fusion, because we have also another factor here. We have a circular motion transferred to straight, which means that the pistons will actually slow down at the peak and at the bottom. So you will have a nice acceleration of the piston movement in the middle and a slower movement exactly where we need the movement to be slow that will give the marbles more time to jump to the next step. So I'm gonna take you through the evolution of the fish stair in the project. I think this is a placeholder. It's the most crude version we had of the first fish stair. I think this is the second fish stair. And what's interesting with this is that here you can see there's 2 rows of marbles next to each other. So it's 8 marbles wide and 2 rows of marbles deep. And I realized that this takes much longer. It takes much longer for these marbles to move to the next step when there's two in every line than only one. And then I guess we came to this. And here I solved the problem of having two marbles deep by having two rows underneath each other. So every step takes 16 marbles. But I'm going to show you what happens if we insert this design into the full assembly. I'm not even going to join it, I'm just going to move it up there. These blocks to the left are sketch blocks where I try to figure out the position of the steps. So you can already see this construction. It looks like the marble machine has a giant ear on the left side. Let's leave it there. So the profile of the... I'm talking purely aesthetics here. The profile, this is unacceptable. As you can see, the overhang to the left is just out of balance, out of touch with the whole design. There was a lot of problems. Where do I demagnetize the marbles? It's ugly, it's awful, it's not nice. And then I came up with this solution. I introduced a very simple belt drive with cages that can take 8 marbles per piece, and they drop them off up here at the bus station on the top of the marble machine. So when the cages turns, the marbles will roll out automatically, and the marbles are safe when the cages are in this direction. And the cages are lifted in increments also by the pistons with a ratchet system. So the cases, thanks to the round movement going into straight movement, the cases will go like wah, 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 and they will stop, load marble, then go fast, stop, load marble, then go fast, in time with the music. I think that is going to look awesome. And then I realized, because the fidgeter was so much of a darling for me, so I realized that I can put a tiny fidgeter with only place for 4 marbles per step, as opposed to 16 before, here. And this little fidgeter can take care of the recycling of marbles that haven't been used in the marble divider. And what is the marble recycling system? So look here, we have 3 lanes going into the marble divider. So the first lane comes in the beginning of the marble divider from the first holes. The second lane drops down in the middle of the marble divider here. The third lane drops down in the end. And when there's marbles that go through all the whole marble divider, but all the channels are full, so the marbles aren't needed, they go out on this side and they go down here into our divide by 8 that we're now going to change into a divide by 5, more on that later, and up in the fish stair. And then in the fish stair drop off, this is the fish stair drop off, and I saw here drop off, and this fish stair drop off is my best design yet in Fusion 360. Not only because how it looks and how it functions, but how I did the cadding of it. And the cool thing with this is that this part will receive 4 marbles, and it has a switch system. So you can switch these, the switch plates here. So now when I switch this position with a single, the marbles that come here will now fall through this hole. And I can switch it to there, and then the marbles will fall in the last opening. And that's important because these 3 different places for the marbles to fall is related to the 3 different lanes of the marble divider. So if we realize that there is one song that needs more marble for the drums, or more marbles for the bass, or more marbles from the beginning, I can just switch the switch plates and have the whole marble recycling loop going straight to that instrument section. I'm really, really excited about this because I didn't have to kill my fish there, darling. We have the belt drive back that people loved on the first machine, and I just like the look of it. The best thing with this system is that we have increased the marble lifting capacity at above 8 marbles per crank turn, because the recycled marbles that comes out of the full marble divider is not congesting the main lifting system of the belt. because they're not even going down there. They're taking care of the fish there. So we have actually increased the feed rate of marble into the marble divider by changing it around this way. So prepare for some techno music. That's the fish there. And remember, this will move in time with the music, like dun dun. I should not sing that song. Dun 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 ta da 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 dun ta da 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 shuff 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 shuff. It's gonna climb back. Dun 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 shuff 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 dum 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 dum. Marbles climb in time of the music. If I play slower, they climb like this. And if we play really fast, they will climb like this. Dun 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 ta da 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 da. Yeah. So, okay. Let's restart the camera. Did I just lose my marbles? No, I have one marble left. That's what we're clinging on to.